You're about to become a mom, or maybe you're a new mom. People talk about it being so blissful and wonderful. They want to rub your pregnant belly. It's supposed to be a time in your life that's full of sunshine and gumdrops. The truth is, for many women, it doesn't always turn out that way. TV personality Nadine Brubeck is here with us this morning, and she's sharing her pregnancy journal, which has just recently turned into a book. Nadine, thanks for coming in. We appreciate it.
Absolutely, Heather. Yeah. Call me crazy, but I published my pregnancy journal, and the big question is, why? Because it's so much personal information. I was diagnosed with complete placenta previa. The first part of my pregnancy was flawless, but then I was told, hey,
at 20 weeks,
Everything changed. I went from perfection to paranoia. Your life is at risk. Your baby's life is at risk. You will likely bleed, be hospitalized, put on bed rest, and birth a preemie. And it's like, okay, well, the perfection blew up in my face.
So you were picturing decorating a nursery and having this extravagant baby shower.
And now a full-term pregnancy.
And now you're in bed for 20 weeks almost.
I'm in bed and I'm in the hospital. I'm in both. And it was a very scary experience. So I actually started writing when we began trying to get pregnant because I thought that was comical. Yes, it was emotionally overwhelming and a little bit stressful. Like, oh my gosh, we're starting a family. Are we going to get pregnant right away? There's a picture of
our
wedding. And this is a funny story. I know I'm kind of going on a tangent here, but he's chucking oysters on New Year's Eve because we had oysters on New Year's Eve when we were trying to conceive that night. I know it's TMI. I know I'm giving you TMI here, but that night, there was a crab in our oyster. There was a baby crab. So we're like, oh my gosh,
This is a sign. It's happening.
And it did happen. And as you can see, you know, we did.
Wait, was that right after you had the baby?
Were
you one of those that looked good after having the baby?
I know you were too, Heather.
Oh, please.
We spent 7 nights in the NICU because Nicholas did end up coming out pretty early. He was born 4/11. He was just my beautiful little dog.
Said he was 6 weeks early. They told you he would probably be premature, and he certainly was. Now, going through your journal and your story, why do you think it's important for other moms to hear about this? Do you think that we all want the experience that we see in the movies of perfection, and for most of us, that's just not how it turns out?
Well, it's a misconception, Heather. You know, obviously, it's very personal, so I toy with it. What am I doing putting this information out there? But at the same time, 1 in 8 babies are born premature every year, okay? And a lot of those premature births are from high-risk pregnancies like the one I had. Now, I didn't really have an outlet, so I wanted to give women an outlet, this book, Expecting Perfect, My Bumpy Journey to Mommyhood, that they can read and say, hey, I'm not alone. Imperfection is okay, and I can relate to this person's story. You don't have to have previa to read my book. My book is for anybody trying to get pregnant, anybody currently pregnant, anybody who's been pregnant, because it's a journey. It's a beautiful experience.
And I do think that the one thing that us women a lot of times learn the hard way is that when it starts from start to finish, trying to get pregnant through having a kid, nothing about it is perfect.
Nothing
is perfect when it comes to that. I know that I was telling you during the commercial break, me having an emergency C-section, I slightly felt cheated out of the whole experience. Did you feel the same way?
Well, you know, Heather, it's funny you say that because we all have our story. You have your emergency C-section story. I have my story, and everybody has their individual story. Did I feel cheated? You know, I wouldn't say cheated is the right word because I ended up getting the most beautiful baby doll in the entire world.
Here's husband Nate with Nicholas.
Yes, you're coming in right on call. So no, I didn't get cheated, but I feel like I was given the story that I had so I can share it. So I could maybe
can we
help
get a
other women.
This baby's face. Can you say mini me? I mean, he looks
he
just
is my
like
mini.
You, and you
he
are too cute you. With your big blue eyes.
This is
Hi.
Nicholas. This is Nicholas.
He's 7 months old now.
7 months old. He's doing fantastic. And I do want women to know it is worth it. Every single second is worth it. And behind every rocky pregnancy and beautiful baby is a supportive husband who's letting me publish my pregnancy journal, as crazy as it is.
So Nate, you're a hero in all this too. I think the husbands sometimes get left behind,
you
and we don't want that to happen.
You need a strong support system.
Nadine, Nate, and you, sweetie pie, little Nicholas, thank you so much for coming on our show.
Absolutely.
And your website, in case people want to pick up the book, is
expectingperfect.com.
Expectingperfect.com.
Thank you, Heather.
Thank you again for your time. Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.